Justin Blackmon's latest DUI says about him as a person. So let's look at some of your responses from today. Okie Muskogee 33 from Twitter says, well, it says that he is a young man in need of good friends, guidance, and a little help to rid himself of alcoholism. I pray he gets it. No proof that he's an alcoholic or that he's suffering from alcoholism, but just Okie from Okie Muskogee's opinion there.
Ben says Blackmon is making a terrible mistake head on. Having DUIs is much worse. It could have been catastrophic.
And that's true.
That is very true.
When you're driving with .24, you know, a lot of people say that's basically a loaded weapon.
Yeah.
So, you know, it thankfully didn't hit anybody else in driving.
This is a, I can't believe that another guy. Well,
didn't injure
that's
himself.
That's just impressive.
At least at this point, looking to be a pretty prolific NFL career, at least a profitable one. Yeah.
There's another guy.
Benjamin says
that's impressive.
Make better
I like
choices.
It.
He has the money not to drive intoxicated. To your point, very lucky to just get a DUI. That's an interesting point too. Now, I don't know that his contract is exactly final yet, so maybe he doesn't quite have the money in the bank. But still, you think a guy that was the number 5 pick in the NFL draft has, you know, a friend he could call, could hire a taxi, heck, even hire, like, what do they call it, a town car, you know?
He can have a limo. He can have a driver. And I actually looked it up. His rookie contract is set to pay him $8,300 a day. Whew. That doesn't go into the fact that he can absolutely afford, and I will get into that here once we get down with the next break, that he can afford to do a cab or limo or anything like that. It also tells me that he has that much money coming in to lose. What if he had killed somebody?
No.
I mean, that's the worst-case scenario, and thank God he didn't. But you have to kind of think about it.
Well, like I said, you know, but not guilty. You don't want to, you know, convict him yet. Just a rough situation based on what happened. And we do wish him the best. I mean, we'd love to see him go on to a long and fantastic NFL career. I think it'd be a great thing for Oklahoma State and for the state of Oklahoma. It could be a wake-up call as well.
Definitely could be.
We have one more block